Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
With your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, I must inform you that this mass is being taped, so we're going to play it tomorrow as a live stream mass. Should I say what I want to say? So we all better be on our best behaviors, right? My dear friends, to prepare yourself to celebrate this sacred mystery, our God loves us so much, and He knows each and every one of us. Our gospel reading today tells us that the Lord knows even the number of hairs on our head. So let us now pause for a moment, and the times that we have doubted God's love, God's care, and God's compassion, let us ask for God's mercy and for God's forgiveness.
Lord Jesus, you are the light shining in the darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, lead us to the Father. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you cast out all our fears. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. The Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you. We bless you. We adore you. We glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Holy Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Jeremiah said, I hear the whisperings of many, terror on every side. Denounce, let us denounce him. All those who were my friends are on the watch for any misstep of mine. Perhaps he will be trapped, then we can prevail and take our vengeance on him. But the Lord is with me, like a mighty champion. My persecutors will stumble, they will not triumph. In their failure, they will be put to utter shame, to lasting, unforgettable confusion. O Lord of hosts, you who test the just, who probe mind and heart, let me witness the vengeance you take on them, for to you I have entrusted my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord, for he has rescued the life of the poor from the power of the wicked. The word of the Lord. The responsorial psalm is, Lord, in your great love, answer me. Lord, in your great love, answer me. For your sake, I bear insult, and shame covers my face. I have become an outcast to my brothers, a stranger to my children, because zeal for your house consumes me, and the insults of those who blaspheme you fall upon me. Lord, in your great love, answer me. I pray to you, O Lord, for the time of your favor, O God. In your great kindness, answer me with your constant help. Answer me, O Lord, for bounteous is your kindness. In your great mercy, turn toward me. Lord, in your great love, answer me. See you lowly ones and be glad. You who seek God, may your hearts revive. For the Lord hears the poor, and his own who are in bonds he spurns not. Let the heavens and the earth praise him, the seas and whatever moves in them. The Lord, in your great love, answer me. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, through one man sin entered the world, and through sin death. And thus death came to all men, inasmuch as all sinned. For up to the time of the law, sin was in the world, though sin is not accounted when there is no law. But death reigned from Adam to Moses, even over those who did not sin, after the pattern of the trespass of Adam, who is the type of the one who was to come. But the gift is not like the transgression, for if by the transgression of the one the many died, how much more did the grace of God and the gracious gift of the one man, Jesus Christ, overflow for the many? The word of the Lord.
Concealed that will not be revealed, nor secret that will not be known. What I say to you in the darkness, speak in the light. What you hear whispered, proclaim on the housetops. And do not be afraid of those who kill the body but cannot kill the soul. Rather, be afraid of the one who can destroy both soul and body in Gehenna. Are not two sparrows sold for a small coin? Yet not one of them falls to the ground without your Father's knowledge. Even all the hairs of your head are counted. So do not be afraid. You are worth more than many sparrows. Everyone who acknowledges me before others, I will acknowledge before my Heavenly Father. But whoever denies me before others, I will deny before my Heavenly Father. The Gospel of the Lord. Back in the 90s, when I was working as a criminal prosecutor, there was a sign on a Lutheran church there on 45 that piqued my interest. It said, If you were charged with being a Christian, would there be enough evidence to convict? And it was sometime around that time, some months later, I heard Deacon Jim Wogan quote that same sign in a homily here. And he did something unusual. He repeated the homily a year later. I finally started to think, maybe I should really be thinking about this. Is there enough evidence to convict me of being a Christian? I took some comfort in Matthew 25, where it talks about those who take care of the homeless and feed the hungry and visit the imprisoned will be welcomed for having done it for the Lord. But that gospel passage addresses all the nations who've never heard of the one God, promising that they too can find salvation. The gospel of Matthew also contains the commandment in tonight's gospel that we have to acknowledge Christ and proclaim him. And the gospel of Matthew leads us with the final instruction to the disciples to go out and make disciples of all nations. I don't know about you, but this charge fills me with intimidation. In former times, people might be put to death for proclaiming God. But now we're frequently shut up simply with the threat of laughter. At least I am. I didn't know when I was listening and considering this sign, this problem of conviction, that already a big part of my ministry as a proclaimer of the gospel, a significant, important part of it was already over. Because my children were well on the way to having grown up and going away to college. In a few years, the social scientists would tell us findings that a father who regularly goes to church can expect that over 70% of such father's children will become regular churchgoers. But a father who does not attend church will only have 2% of his offspring become regular churchgoers. And if his wife is regular while he's irregular, only 1/3 of his offspring will become churchgoers. So already an important part of my proclamation was accomplished. I would only later realize how important fathers are and how much I owe just my presence in church today to the example and the leadership of my father and my grandfather who took me to church. But what do I do with this fear of proclaiming, and how do I do it effectively in this world full of noise? I think the suggestion is to do it as Jesus does it today, to whisper and speak in silence and in darkness, to bring a soft voice, to first learn how to acknowledge Jesus routinely in my life. When people ask me, how was my weekend? Well, I mention how important it was going to Mass. If I eat out at one of the restaurants opening up now, well, I think of saying grace before my meal and making the sign of the cross with confidence. When a friend or a colleague of mine uses the name of Jesus disrespectfully, can I discreetly and quietly let that friend know, this name is important to me. Please treat it with respect. And I'm finding that by using the soft words, but routinely acknowledging what is important in my life, people come to me when it's time for them to learn. And they're given grace to ask me, and then we engage in freewheeling conversations, and suddenly I'm a proclaimer. The grace of God works like this. So this is what I'm slowly learning over decades after reading that sign. Yes, to be convicted of being a Christian, my only judge is Jesus, who will bring me to the Father, or not acknowledge me to the Father. If I'm going to be convicted of being a Christian, I have to love my neighbor and love God. But part of that is to share God's love for all my brothers and sisters by bringing the word of God to them. There is no conviction of being a Christian without a confession, and without routine confession of my convictions that Jesus is Lord and there is good news for all of us. Now, when we say our creed today, let us do it with confidence, but also pray for the grace to bring that same
Let us now together profess our faith in our God. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. Brothers and sisters, gathered together by Christ, let us lift up our prayers and petitions to our Heavenly Father, who knows all our needs.
Our response is, Lord, accept our prayer. For the church, that we may cultivate a feeling of welcome and encourage participation of all people of all cultures, ethnicities, and backgrounds, we pray.
Lord, accept our prayer.
For our world leaders, may they peacefully lead with equality, fairness, and justice, we pray.
Lord, accept our prayer.
For all fathers and stepfathers, grandfathers and godfathers, for all men who serve and nurture young people, for their strength and tenderness, courage and wisdom, generosity and faithfulness, we pray.
Lord, accept our prayer.
For an end to the coronavirus and for those who are helping us during this time, that they may be protected from the virus and blessed with the strength to persevere, we pray.
Lord, accept our prayer.
For those who are sick and have asked for our prayers, and for those who are affected with the coronavirus both physically and emotionally, we pray.
Lord, accept our prayer.
We remember those who have died, most recently Chris Jersky, and also for Mary and Richard Rallo and Barry Lamb. For those we love and miss, for those who are mourning the passing of a dear one, and for those who die with no one to pray for them, we pray.
Lord, accept our prayer.
For all our own intentions, those in our book of prayers, our bulletin, and within our hearts, we pray.
Lord, accept our prayer. Good and gracious God, hear the prayers we lift up to you today. Ease our fears and anxiety so that we may rely only on your love and care, so that one day we may enjoy the reward of everlasting life with you in heaven, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
So, Lord,
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that this sacrifice of yours and mine may be acceptable to the Lord, the God Almighty. Amen. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for his own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving you thanks, said a blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice once more, giving you thanks. Gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have helped us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Blaise, our Cardinal Archbishop, and other clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages will be married to the co-heirs of eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus the Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. please stand. Let us now together pray in the words our Savior prayed when he was here on earth. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all unnecessary and useless anxieties as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I give you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of Christ be always with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lord Jesus, we know you are truly present in this Eucharist. We thank you for your many gifts and blessings to each of us. We ask you to teach us how to pray, increase our faith, keep us focused on the mission you have called us. And Lord, please do not let us depart from you.
Behold Jesus. Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption through Christ our Lord. Amen. Once again, I just want to thank each and every one of you for being here this evening. This is the first 5 p.m. Mass we're celebrating in more than 3 months, and this is the first one we're recording or taping for to be played later on. So we're still learning and adapting on how to live in this COVID-19 or coronavirus time. So please bear with us, we're doing our best. As you know, once the Mass is over, we ask you to remain on your seat. The greeters will direct you on how to leave, beginning from the back to the front, just the reverse of how you came in. And we also have in the narthex 2 boxes for our collection. So if you have your envelopes, please do drop it there. We still have to pay electric bill and utilities, right? So we thank you. And then also we ask you, out of consideration for fellow parishioners, once you register to be at any mass and you realize you're unable to do so, if you can please call to cancel or cancel the registration so that other people have the opportunity to worship with us, because we have a limited number of people that can fit at the mass for celebration. So if you're not able to do so, please do make sure you cancel your reservation. And we ask you to please sign up our, you know, the sign up genius reservation will open every Monday morning for the following weekends, okay? So for the following weekend, you can begin from Monday and do it as soon as possible. And once you realize you won't be able to join us, please, if you can cancel. We will only open one weekend at a time, not two weekends, but one. They are required for Sunday and daily masses, no exception. So if you're going to be here for any of the masses, please make sure you do sign up. There's no exception. And the reason is to keep every one of us safe and to know the number of people that will be here. We have moved our reconciliation time to 4 p.m. on Saturdays, and the reconciliation will be from 4 to 4:30 p.m. in the chapel. Okay? So, and all this we do just to keep everyone safe. If you are in need of a retreat, join St. Mary of Vernon and St. Joseph, Libertyville, for a day of reflection called Pausing for Prayer on July 18th at St. Joseph. Please see the website for details and to register. Information will also be in the next week's bulletin. So if you want to do a retreat, it's July 18th at St. Joseph. Please do sign up. And as we celebrate Father's Day this weekend, we have a blessing for our fathers. If I may ask the fathers to please bow their heads, the fathers here, and if everyone else around them, I was going to say extend your hands, but hey, so just let's pray for our fathers. Fathers, please bow your heads. God, our Father, in your wisdom and love, you made all things. Bless this man, that they may be strengthened as Christian fathers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. May we honor them always, we their sons and daughters, with a spirit of profound respect. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us give them a round of applause. So on behalf of our staff and our deacons and our entire parish, I want to wish all fathers and all men of St. Mary of Vernon a very holy, blessed Father's Day weekend. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Well, we are getting used to it. It's been a long time since I'm a deacon.
We are called, we are chosen, we are Christ for one another. We are promised to tomorrow, while we are born in today. We are sign, we are wonder, we are sower, we are seed, we are harvest, we are hope, we are question, we are greed. Then where can we stand justified?